Check out the links in my description for more information, for more resources. Check out the podcasts. Check out the Facebook groups. You know, just check out the links. There's a lot of great stuff there. Comment, rate, subscribe, share, like, dislike, you know, whatever you want to do.
This is my Zamasu Gogeta Tournament Tide deck. One copy of the leader. Four Gogeta Frenzy Burst. Four Android 17 Tournament Tide. Four Vegeta Rise of Super Warrior. Four Vegeta Ready to Rumble. Four Gohan Baby's Minion. Four Gohan Power Unshackled. Four Frieza's Universe 7 United. Four Majin Fire Way Supreme Kai. Four Kabuto Kai's Attendant. Four Goku and Vegeta Saiyan Synergy. Four All Too Easy. Four PyCon. Four Raditz Giant Force. Four Gotenks Absolute Unison. And four Goku Protector of the Earth. So, obviously, the goal here, one of our win cons is Gogeta Frenzy Burst, because he has the active main that once per turn. If you have 15 or more energy, choose up to 4 of your opponent's life and place at the bottom of their deck. So, obviously, you will do up to 4. So, if they have 4 life, all 4 to the bottom of their deck, right? And you'll win just because they have more life in their life, right? No more cards in the life. So, of course, it costs 10 to play him, so we got to ramp up to that, right? But we also have to ramp up to 15 just to even use that ability. So, the way we're going to be doing that is we're going to use Vegeta, same for Vegeta Rise of the Super Warrior, use his ability to take the top 4 cards of our deck. If they're blue, put them into our energy, and the deck is mono blue, so any 4 cards from the top of our deck will just go straight to our energy. So we're ramping 4 right off the bat. But we're going to need more than 4. So the idea is for us to play him more than once. And the likelihood of getting 2 copies at a time. So like I was saying, you know, we're going to ramp it up. And the likelihood of us getting 2 copies of Vegeta to ramp to get us at least 8 energy. And of course, we only need 6 to play him. So if we play him on turn 6 and get 4 energies, and then turn 7 play 4 more, play another copy, right? Get 4 more energy on top of this, the 4 we already have, so that's 8 on top of 7. That's a total of 14 energy. So by turn 8, we'll charge energy, and we should be at 15 by turn 8. So the goal is to try to survive to turn 8. I mean, we could ramp sooner, right? We could try to ramp our energy faster than that. And of course, we have stuff for that. One way to help us get Vegeta out sooner is Majin the Fire by Supreme Kai. Play this on turn 2, so that way on turn 5, we can drop Vegeta and get the 4 energy rolling. But of course, after that, we'll have 9 energy, then we'll charge on turn 6. So on turn 6, we should have 10 energy if we do that. And 10 energy is enough to play Gogeta, but not enough for his effect. So we'll need 5 more turns after that, right? Or technically 2 more turns, because we'll try to play a second Vegeta. But the likelihood of us getting 2 copies is slim, so bouncing it back to hand and replaying it would be a strategy. And that's where Kabuto Kai comes in. So that's why he's in there. So we can use, so he acts as another copy of Vegeta. He doesn't only serve that purpose, he has other purpose. The other purpose for him is for us to reuse our Vegeta Ready Rumble, our Gohans, you know, these are our floodgate negates, which should keep us in the game longer, so we can charge an energy every turn and ideally ramp, especially through the effect of Vegeta, so we can ramp up real quick and try to get to 15 so we can use Gogeta as our win con. Or just go into Turn of Tide and use that as a win con. So those are 2 of our main win cons in the deck. Another way we can win is obviously through time, by having more life than our opponent, through PyCon's rejuvenate ability to gain a life. So that's our main stuff, and we have this Gohan also acts as a floodgate Has an ability active main where you send it to the drop. I pay one energy, blue energy, and your opponent can't attack with battle cards unless they send a two cost or less battle card from their side of field to the bottom of the deck every time they attack. So it's the reverse version of Goku Unison. His auto is your opponent, in order for your opponent to attack, he has to send a two cost or higher battle card to the bottom of the deck in order to attack. So he's the reverse version. So your opponent has to send high cost battle cards for this card's effect, but for this card effect, they have to use low cost battle cards. And the likelihood your opponent having 3 costs and 4 costs, you know, battle cards are more common than than, you know, 2 costs or less. So the fact that once you play this and triggered, the likelihood your opponent just not being able to play with battle cards, period, is very high. So it's nice to have him there as an added card. But he goes to the drop, so it makes it hard for us to abuse him with Kibito Kai. But we do have Gohan's Baby's Minion, which we can abuse with Kibito Kai. And we have Vegeta Ready to Rumble, which we can also use repeatedly. And of course, he's also a blocker, so that gives us added defense. So kind of, I prefer to use Oceanus, but I wanted to keep this deck mono blue, so he substitutes Oceanus. Like, I would rather play Oceanus, but, you know, he works, and he's blue, so that's the thing. But if I was playing a deck where I didn't need blue because of Vegeta, for example, then I would go Oceanus instead. We got Frieza just as a reusable blocker that has barriers, so that's always nice to have. And the fact that he plays, you can play him from the drop, makes him very useful as Z energy, because you'll bring him back for 3, right? Then you combo him so he goes in Z energy, and then use him to Z energy. Speaking of Z energy, got to mention our Z deck. We have 2 Majin Buu Pure Destroyer, which is our generic one drop blocker, since blue doesn't have one yet. Kind of odd that we don't. And then we got our board wipe with Sil, so it's 2 of him. We have 2 Raja 21 name for of hunger. In the name of hunger, she's ramp. So she's our Whis, so she will help us ramp. So she could be our turn 4 play, so we can ramp up to 5 energy. Well, technically a turn 3 play, because you play Majin the Fire in turn 2, so that way in turn 3 you can play her. You can play her and ramp up. That way, that'll be 3. By turn 4, you should have 5 energy plus Majin the Fire, that's 6, so you could potentially on turn four, drop Vegeta and ramp 4 more energy. So, just a way to ramp up the strategy. And again, it can help you get to Android 17 Turn Tide if need be. The irony is, even just playing Turn Tide early, control the board, right, by emptying out your opponent's hand, and then just play with your opponent's hand size being small, you know, is a strategy in itself. You don't have to play Turning Tide as a win con. You could use it as just a control strategy. Just play them just to make it hard for your opponent. Obviously, you play them, and then you activate all your effects that lets you draw, so you can refill your hand, so you can have, you know, hand advantage. So there's a strategy there. She also helps you because she has a Z-Stack ability and a permanent that lets you use one of your opponent's battle cards for her Z-Stack ability. So you can remove a battle card with that. She's also a blocker, so that comes in handy. And like I said, she ramps, and she can help you get rid of one of your opponent's battle card. So she can get rid of 2 battle cards, one through her Z-Stack, one through her auto, and then she ramps you in energy and rest mode. And then she can gain, once per turn, the ability of one of the battle cards that's under her. And typically, I like to just, like, grab barrier so she could be a barrier blocker, or maybe triple attack or something of that nature. Or dual attack is nice, so that way you can attack and defend, right? So you can attack with her, restand, and then use her block, so you can do the Sword and Shield strategy. So it just depends what abilities you get. And this acts as, like, our ultimate, since we don't have Hatch yet in the deck. This acts as our ultimate, you know, he's deflect, barrier, blocker, and he's a 30k triple strike that we can, you know, obviously take advantage of. He has auto at the end of each of your turns, switch his card to active mode, choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards and place it at the bottom of your own deck, and your opponent places one card from the hand at the bottom of the deck. So it comes ahead. So if you don't win with him, all right, well, you'll be able to use him to block. He is a barrier blocker, and then your opponent will lose a battle card and a card from the hand. So it makes it hard for them for the clapback, right? Which is always good. So there's that. And like I said, the Majin Buu is just, he's just there just because of his blocker effect until we get a actual blue one drop blocker Z battle card for the arch, you know, for the color. Raditz is our main, you know, draw engine, blocker. So you definitely want to get him out as soon as possible. So you can start drawing since the leader doesn't draw on the awakened side. It technically does, but you don't want to lose life in order to try to draw. You better wait until you're forced. Don't try to turbo yourself into your awakened side. You know, let your opponent force you. Also, we use this leader because of the fact that he has essentially two health bars. So, you know, we'll be able to stay in the game longer. So being able to get to turn 8 or even sooner than that and doing our